are here. It is, I don't know, Saturday, August 13th. We are in Central Park, and we are going to walk around. We're in the rear of Central Park, so we're going to walk around and show you the different restaurants. All my favorite restaurants are up here because, as the name of the channel implies, I don't like crowds. So I like it up here because it's a little more peaceful, a little more personal space. So there we go. One of the restaurants that you have to pay a dining upgrade to get, and we ate here on our last cruise, which was on Oasis of the Seas, and it had really good cheese boards, I remember. What else, Andrew, what else did you like from the food here?
I feel like 150 Central Park has a little bit of everything from every other restaurant.
Okay, so we've got roast beef salad, pumpkin bisque, Caesar salad, honey glazed scallops, duck, seared loin, hand-seared halibut, veal medallions, lamb wellington, lobster thermidor. I'm probably saying that wrong, I don't know. Cauliflower steak. I don't have my glasses on, so my earrings are wrong. And then the artisanal cheese selection, fried cheesecake, peanut butter chocolate tart, hazelnut passion fruit bar. Those all sound great. Let's walk in and just see the ambiance. I think these cute. I love these little chairs. This is like so cute for two. Look at this. This is adorable. Like, perfect date night with these little guys, and very Instagrammable. Oh, and apparently they have Louis the 13th, if you're a cognac person. I don't drink soda. All right, back out in Central Park. This is the Rising Tide Bar. It goes up and down, and you can drink on it. Personally, that makes me get seasick even thinking about it, and I don't get seasick, but apparently it's fun. There's a cute little fountain. Okay, oh, and let's go around. Shops is over here. Okay, and now we're going to Chops Grill, which is right across from Central Park. This is one of my favorite spots for lunch. This is one of the dining upgrade restaurants that's open for lunch. You can do lunch reservations here. Great salmon. Okay, let's see. So they have filet, petite filet, prime rib, New York strip steak, rack of lamb, roast chicken, crispy goat salad, wedge salad, Caesar, lobster bisque, wild mushroom, and that was delicious. I got that last time. Oh, and the appetizers, the colossal shrimp cocktail, we got that last time, and it was lump crab cakes, also really good. Grilled black pepper bacon. And let's just go in and take a look. So this is the main dining area. Very pretty, nice and cool. They probably have a great wine selection looking at the wall, but again, I don't know because I don't drink. So I feel like I've said that too many times in this tour. I keep being like, I don't drink. It's not really that deep. I just feel like an alcohol suggestion should be included, but also by someone who is knowledgeable in these matters. So they have a trellis bar. This is a cute place. It's nice in the evening. They usually have live music out here. And now we're coming up on Park Cafe. Park Cafe, I believe, is included. So you can just come in here and grab snacks. As I recall, it was not the best. But maybe it'll be different on this ship.
Yeah, I mean, it's good for things like yogurt. Things that you can just keep cold.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then they have an eating area over there. So.
Usually the staff on board is really nice.
Yeah, the staff is super friendly. I think the best staff ever of all the cruise lines we've gone on is on Royal, in my opinion. Oh, and this is my absolute favorite place on the entire ship. Giovanni's table. I love Italian, and as you may know from watching this channel, we are pescatarians. So pasta is a big friend of mine. Not my waistline, but I love it. And so they have a cheese board, which we got last time, super good caprese salad. We also got very good eggplant parmigiana, arugula salad, crispy calamari, the carbonara, gnocchi gorgonzola. I got that was amazing. Seafood linguine, pasta bolognese, wild mushroom risotto. We got that too. That was the best, one of the best things I had on this ship. They've got branzino, they've got garlicky herb prawns, which we never tried, but it sounds good. Chicken piccata, seared filet. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce that. And then they have chocolate hazelnut cake, cannoli, panna cotta. So classic Italian fare, absolutely delicious. I think last time we got like the pasta of the night, right, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And it was like, it's not on the menu, but I think sometimes if you ask them like, what's your pasta of the day, they'll have a special. Delicious, best ever. Okay, let's go check it out. And they have this outdoor dining, which is really nice because at night they'll have musicians out here. And it's. Hi, bonjour.
Hello, hi. Thank you.
So you can see there's pasta maker. Mm-hmm. So cute. This is the interior of the restaurant. Super pretty. And they have a great wine selection too. Mm-hmm. So well,
that's new. Fits for this portrait studio. You know what that is?
So because we're doing a mini tour, we're gonna tour the things that like we care about. So that's probably not gonna include like a lot of the shopping. We're gonna try to keep it brief. Look at these are all real flowers too, just so you guys know. Like they have thousands of live plants in here. Like you can see there's like actual dirt. They water them. It's so beautiful. It smells great. You can see everybody with the interior balconies. Oh, there's Vintages, which I think is a wine bar, if I recall correctly.
Yeah, that's not an Oasis either.
Yeah, that's different from Oasis. So I might be totally wrong about what it is. I don't know. We'll add notes in the editorial section. I'm wrong.
Look, there's wine in the window.
Yeah,
Oh, yeah, there's wine along the walls. So, yep. Called it.
I don't know it for a fact, yeah. But I'm pretty sure it's a wine bar.
Yep.
Hi, everybody. We're back. We're on deck 15, which is where the pools are. So, let's go check it out. Okay, so over here you have a series of cocktails. So there's some here, there's some over on the other side. Waiting chair in the water, and by the way, good tip for cruising, get up early, like real early, and designate your seats because they go fast. And also another great tip for the pool is have your dinner early and then come up and swim while everybody else is at dinner because then the pools won't be packed. So here's the pool. And there's an identical one on the other side. Pools, and then 2 feet 9 inches on the other side of that. So if you do have a smaller child, you would want to keep an eye on them around that. And then we've got this pool that is apparently deeper than 3 feet. And then we've got some nice loungers out here. Here. And then these are some like nice shady loungers if you don't want to be in the sun all day or if you don't want the wind. Sometimes it gets real windy up here. Nice view downtown Gas. Have good guacamole here. But not open yet, because we got on the ship super early. Like, if it seems like, oh, it's not super busy, it's really chill there, it's not crowded, it's because we got on, like, an hour before we were even supposed to. Trust me, it will get packed. There's sports court, basketball, soccer.
A local fresh is included, yeah. Complimentary dining.
Yeah, that's included in the menu. Oh, here, let's get a good. This is a great one. So from up here, right by a local fresh, you can see down. And you can see where they do the water show. Do you want to walk up and get them? I'm not going to the edge. Oh my God.
And down there is a boardwalk. They typically have a Johnny Rockets. I see the checkered floor and red umbrellas. That does look to be a Johnny Rockets. And we'll have another bar. Sometimes they'll have a sports bar there. On this side of the ship, you also have the rock climbing wall, and as Emily pointed out, right at the, is it the bow or the stern?
What?
Is it the back?
The stern.
At the stern of the ship, on the way of the seas, is the Aqua Theater, and there we'll be attending one of their excellent performances of really talented acrobatic athletes and swimmers and dancers.
Ping pong tables coming up. Ping pong. That's your bag. And then here's the putt-putt course.
Which is also complimentary.
Yes. many holes it is. I would assume 9. But I don't know because I've never done it. Alrighty, here is one of the funnest things on the ship, the flow rider. It's a little windy up here. For the flow riders, you can stand or you can like belly board on it. Oh, there, look, they got a whole sign that shows you how to do it. It doesn't really matter though, because in the end, you'll just fall. But unless you're talented, which I'm not.
Here is the zip line. It's a line that goes across.
Oh,
top of the ship, yep. Yeah. Starts here at under that awning.
Oh,
and ends there at that red landing zone.
And then head down to the rock climbing wall. You can see.
Oh, yep. And there is the rock climbing.
You can climb up a whole, like, what is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like 4 stories now? Yeah, I mean, you can get up there. That's not a junior rock climbing wall. Really. Okay. And then this is another really beautiful picture of the ship. Spas, or hot tubs, I guess, that are kind of in like the bulge of the ship, so they protrude out.
No.
You can get in here and look out of the ocean. Here you get a lovely view of the shrimp boats, which I think is actually really cool. But yeah, these are great. And there's actually two of them. They're separated. It's the same water, but they're separated by a little barrier. But they have little seats in there, and they turn the bubbles on. I don't know what the like more educated term for that is.
Jets.
There we go. They have jets. And these are right across from the windjammer, I think. We're on the 16th floor towards the bow of the ship, right in front of the solarium. So no, it's not by the windjammer. It's just in the bow of the ship and right in front of the solarium on the 16th floor. There you go. Okay, and this is the solarium. It is nice because it is an adults-only area. So while the back of the ship has a lot of features for children, this has a lot of features for adults. This also has Samba Grill, which I think is different than Oasis.
Yeah.
But
Oasis has a solarium cafe.
It's included, and we'll have to see. I'll have to look in here, but let's see. They have chicken breast wrapped in bacon, beef ribs, cured pork sausage, sirloin, herb crusted pork loin, picanha, chopped sirloin. So a lot of beef. Oh, it's a Brazilian steakhouse. Okay. I don't know if that's included or not, but here's a solarium. We'll add it in. The solarium is nice. It's very relaxing. It's covered, so you don't get a ton of wind up here. Beautiful live flowers. And you have awesome jacuzzi. Great at night. Again, like in the day, this will be mobbed. But at night, if you come up here, like especially during like peak dining hours, you'll really be able to get some spaces kind of to yourself. And we've got these beautiful water pumps. And then here's the pool. Kind of a waiting pool. Oh, it has these lovely loungers. These are great to get in the daytime. You just post your stuff up in here. You can kind of use it as a base. And they're really nice, especially in there if they're in the shade, because it gets hot. You get a lot of sun out here in the Caribbean, especially in the summer. So it's good to have a base that's a little shady. And so, like I said, you have jacuzzi on the aft side, pool in the center, and then another jacuzzi on the port side. I got that right, too. Port's on the left, starboard is on the right. So there we go. I got it right. I'm becoming a little sailor.
Always remember it, because port is a liquor. Liquor is evil and bad.
Oh my God,
and
no.
The church.
That's how I remember it. I remember it because I'm left-handed. Left evil. And I'm yeah. Like, if I was going to reach for a glass of port, even though for the third time, I don't drink. People are going to be like, oh God, that girl must have been such an alcoholic. No, I don't know. Just keeps coming up because I feel like I would, if I knew what I was doing, I would be making wine selections for all of the restaurants, but I am not educated in that area, so I feel like I have to disclaim it at every restaurant we go to. But the way that I remember the port and starboard, right? Port and starboard. The way that I remember that is if I was going to reach for a glass of port, I would reach for it with my left hand because I'm left-handed. So here's another jacuzzi. And then let's see if we can find the windjammer. And then try to get some food,
some starving. Yeah, it is right in front of us, and it's in the middle of the ship.
Oh, okay. I don't even know if it's open.
It says it's open on the app.
Okay.
So another hot tip. If you're not sure if a restaurant is open or where it's located on the ship, you can open up your Royal Caribbean app.
Yeah, the Royal Caribbean app is super helpful.
There's a tab that shows you exactly what is open right now.
So now we're back in the central pool area again. We'll probably cut this out because we've wandered through here a few times. It's probably confusing.
Yeah, a lot of the time, depending on the time of day, you'll have one side that is really nicely shaded.
Yeah. Okay, so. A little out of breath because I just went up the stairs from deck 15 to deck 16 where the Windjammer Marketplace is at the stern of the ship. But I wanted to stop and share this beautiful view of the pools and the hot tubs and the kids' water area. So it's very pretty. I don't know if I'm going to be able to use this because they're playing music and YouTube doesn't like it when you have copyrighted music anywhere in your video. So we'll see. But now let's go get some food and air conditioning. Hello.
Hi, hello. Welcome aboard. Welcome to Pajama's Marketplace. Enjoy your meal and have a wonderful day.
Thank you.
Happy, happy, happy.
Buffet, it's included. We've got Coca-Cola station.
Which is not included.
Yes, that you have to pay extra for in the beverage package.
But they do have often lemonade or tea or water that's
yeah,
included.
Lemonade, which I will be getting now because I am, ooh, strawberry kiwi.
We'll try that.
Yeah. And they got lots of ice in here, so these are nice and cold. Delicious. Oh, look at these cute little salads. Garbanzo salad. Little Caesar salad. I love a Caesar, always. Cheeses. Oh, look, they got veggie burgers.
Hey.
Oh, and it's like a do-it-yourself burger station.
Good for us.
So you can pick all your buns, your accoutrements, everything you want.
An assortment of hot sauces and steak sauces.
Nice little roast station. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mashed potatoes, corn on the cob, gravy, applesauce, beef goulash, sauteed zucchini, guava beans, ooh, cauliflower curry.
This is a whole vegetarian section.
Oh, the whole vegetarian section. Yeah. Roast pumpkin, polenta fries. Ooh, that looks really good.
Yeah.
As you can see, it's a little crowded in here already. Oh, there's fresh fruit. Ooh, and they got pineapple too. I'm gonna get some of that. Pasta station. Yes. I love my pastas. I love all food, but especially anything with carbs.
We have the Asian corner, some fried rice.
Yeah.
Stir-fried vegetables, some chili oils.
Stir-fried vegetables. One of the things I love about these buffets on the ship is that they have, like, because the crews are so diverse, they have a million, like, different kinds of food, but it's done well. It's not, like, tacky, flavorless Asian food or Mexican food or Brazilian food. It's always really good because they have people from these countries that help make it, so they know what they're doing. So you get, like, real quality food. Grilled fish with caper salad. Okay, I think that's it. So we're gonna sign off and we're gonna actually eat because I'm starving and I haven't eaten yet today. So bonsoir.
Start.
Hi everybody. So we've gotten our food at Windjammer. It's, as you can see, it's very crowded here. It's a bit of a competitive sport, so I recommend that you get up here and don't be shy to jump in line and get what you want. But there's a lot of great food. Like I said, great Indian food, great vegetarian food, great Asian food. So I got some mac and cheese, some pasta. I made like a pomodoro sauce with a mix of the Alfredo and the tomato sauce. Polenta fries, curried cauliflower, and Indian dal, which is kind of like a weird mix for lunch, but I want to try it all. So we're gonna try all of it and I will let you know how it is. So, mac and cheese is good. Definitely good. The lentil dal is really good too, actually. Could use a little bit of salt maybe, but really good. The cheesy pasta with my homemade pomodoro sauce. And like when I said I like a lot of Parmesan, I'm not kidding. Like I will drown it. There will be more Parmesan than pasta. This is the best so far. Let me try a little nug of this curried cauliflower because like I don't know about all this food together, but it all looked good, so it's really good too. All right, so and then last thing is the polenta fries. It's probably not gonna be the most attractive thing to eat on film, but I'm just gonna do it. They're good. Probably eat them in two bites. All right, hi everybody, welcome back. We are on deck 4 in the bow of the ship at the Amber Theater, so we're just gonna walk in, show you a quick look. I think this is where they do like the stage productions. Like I know on Oasis they did Cats. I'm not sure what they're doing on here. But yeah, let's go and take a look.
Hi guys, how you doing?
We're just eating
with
your theater.
Oh no, great. Feel free. You're welcome. Let us know if you need anything.
Thank you.
Have a good one, guys.
So here's the theater. Beautiful, lots of seats. And they do Broadway productions in here, which is nice. So, sure. All right. And it has a whole upper level, too. No. All right, now let's go up, maybe. So now we walked up to deck 5. This is not my favorite deck. It's a little chaotic for me, as I said. I'll try to say it nicely. Like, I'm just not a fan of crowds. It makes me anxious. Like, I love people, all people, everybody individually as people, but in groups, they give me anxiety. But here's your Starbucks. The people are on the boat, so it gives like crazy crowded on here.
Every passenger comes through that
concert. Yeah, it's so crowded. Like, I hate it. So. Regalia. One of the really popular spots on the boat is Sorrento's, the pizza place. Supposedly the pizza on there is really good. I never tried it because the line was always like halfway through here, so it just wasn't worth it to me. They have your liquor station, cigarettes, you can buy all your duty-free spices over there that you want. Bow and Stern is really popular. It's like a British-style pub. You can see the chaos that is Sorrento's. And just the general chaos down here. Which is why we here at the Antisocial Travel Channel avoid this deck like the plague. But I am braving it to show it to you all. Here's the Promenade Cafe. I think it's like a 50s diner style. It's free, it's included with your trip. There's Next Cruise if you want to book a cruise. I think you get some like minor discount for booking there.
There's the Rising Tide Bar.
Yes, this is the bottom of the Rising Tide Bar. We showed you the top earlier. Kind of sketch. Not a fan. Pretty fountain though.
Allure of the Seas has a champagne and martini bar. I don't think that was on Oasis of the Seas.
Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. And now we're gonna go up to the promenade and out of that chaos. What deck is the promenade?
Deck 6.
Oh, okay, perfect.
Okay.
Alrighty, here we go.
The boardwalk.
The boardwalk. Okay. So this is more my speed because there aren't 20 people within 6 inches of me. So, oh, and they have Zoltar, look. This is so cute. I love this. This is from the Tom Hanks movie Big, right? Yeah. It's very fun. So we can play that. They have a carousel. We have the hot dog house, that's included. And then, I think the carousel is really cute. Like, I love like the classic designs they did on all the horses and animals. They really put in the time to like detail them and make them have that classic like 1900s carousel feel. Here's the arcade. If you're like me and you love claw machines, this is your spot. And then they have Johnny Rockets, which is again like a 50s style diner. Do you remember that that's included in the dining package?
It is extra, but they typically sometimes have an included breakfast at Johnny Rockets.
And Sabor is the tequila.
Taqueria,
there we go. And tequila bar, which is not included, right? It's upgraded dining?
I believe it is upgraded dining.
Yeah, but it's worth it because who doesn't love good Mexican food? And then here we are at the Aqua Theater. Right. There's the rock climbing wall. This is, you've seen it from above and now you can see it from below. And
there's a rock climbing wall.
This is a lot of fun. So if you are not like a shows person, which I'm about it, I would definitely recommend doing this. They do a spectacular, they those huge high jumps up there, they jump off of that. Those big like wires, they like zip down them and do little flips. And where that blue floor is, it drops down and it becomes a pool. It's really cool. Like, it's definitely worth seeing. It's beautiful, it's outdoors. So if you get kind of claustrophobic indoors, which I don't know if you've noticed, but I kind of do if there's a lot of crowds, then this is just great because it's just, it's outside, you have the fresh air, and they put on a really cool show. So like, if indoor theater things are not your bag, then you're gonna be crazy.
No, there's crazy things happening on the screen behind you.
Oh, there are crazy things happening on the screen. Okay. Anyways, yeah, highly recommend. They have nice, cute little lawn chairs. It's like, you have to reserve it on your app. So like, the best way to do this is to reserve on your app like weeks before you get on your cruise. Like, reserve your entertainment, because it's free, it's included with the cruise, but you can reserve it on the app on your phone. I mean, I don't know how long before. We usually do it like a month before or a few weeks before, so I don't know exactly when they open up, but it's definitely something you want to check for and get ahead of time, because if you wait until you're on the boat, you might not get those good shows, and you might only get like a day when you're in port. And like, speaking from experience, like, after you have swam all day in the Caribbean or walked around all day in Chichen Itza, you will probably be pretty burned out and you might just want to lay in your bed and recuperate and not do an aqua show. So definitely recommend making those reservations way before your sail day and not on port days. So yeah, I think that's it. And we are on deck 6. This is where the main aqua theater is. Like I said, it's free, but you have to make reservations, and they will have you line up here on deck 6 beforehand and come early, because it's first come, first served seating. So get here, line up, and get good seats. All right.